In the heart of Saudi Arabia's capital, an ambitious vision has rapidly unfolded beneath the desert sun and deep beneath the desert sand. The Riyadh Metro, a cornerstone of the Saudi Arabia's Vision 2030, emerges as a beacon of progress, promising to redefine the essence of urban mobility in the city. Saudi Arabia is known for its infrastructure projects, and this project is a catalyst for economic growth, environmental sustainability, and enhanced quality of life for millions of residents and visitors. This will actually be the second metro system in Saudi Arabia, the fourth on the Arabian Peninsula, and the sixth in the Arab world, and the 15th in the Middle East. Step on board as we discuss the finer details of this amazing construction project, including the laying of the first tracks, the completion of intricate tunneling, and the unveiling of the architectural stunning stations. The genesis of the Riyadh Metro project traces back to the early 2010s, when Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia, began to experience unprecedented urban growth. With a population growing at a rapid pace, the city's existing transportation infrastructure found itself at the brink of saturation, leading to an increased traffic congestion and rising environmental concerns. In response to these challenges, and in alignment with the broader goals of Saudi Arabia's Vision 2030 to diversify the economy and improve public services, the Saudi government unveiled ambitious plans for the Riyadh Public Transport Project. At the heart of this comprehensive initiative was the Riyadh Metro, envisioned as a state-of-the-art urban transit system designed to transform the city's transportation landscape. The planning phase of the Riyadh Metro was marked by meticulous strategizing and collaboration with global experts in urban planning, transportation, and sustainability. The project was conceived to encompass six metro lines spanning over 176 kilometers, designed to weave through the city, connecting key districts, government facilities, cultural sites, and commercial areas. Their aim was to create a metro system that not only alleviated traffic congestion, but also enhanced the city's connectivity, economic vitality, and overall quality of life. Groundbreaking commenced in 2014, setting the wheels in motion for what was to become one of the most complex and expansive public transport projects in the world. The projected timeline for the Riyadh Metro's full operational readiness has been adjusted in response to the project's ambitious scope and the unforeseen challenges encountered along the way. Initially anticipated to welcome passengers by 2021, the latest updates point towards a revised completion date in 2024. The financial narrative of the transportation system is as grand as the project itself, with a budget that underscores the Saudi government's commitment to transformative urban development. The project's total investment is estimated to exceed $22 billion, a figure that encompasses the cost of state-of-the-art infrastructure, cutting-edge technology, and meticulous urban integration. The Riyadh Metro is set to redefine urban mobility in the Saudi capital. Its comprehensive rail network, meticulously planned and strategically laid out, promises to connect the farthest corners of Riyadh, weaving through the urban fabric with precision and efficiency. The metro network has six lines, each color-coded and designed to serve distinct areas and purposes within the city. The blue line stretches over 38 kilometers, bridging north to south. It connects the pulsating heart of Olaya Street to the serene stretches of Al Hayer Road, featuring 22 stations, including critical interchanges at Olaya and the architectural marvel of the King Abdul Metro Station. The red line spans 25.3 kilometers from east to west, linking King Abdul Road to the iconic King Fahd Stadium. Its 13 stations facilitate east-west transit, with a crucial interchange at the busy Al Olaya Metro Station. The green line traces King Abdul Aziz Road, acting as a rich link from the historic King Abdul Aziz Historical Center to the strategic Riyadh airbase, over 12.9 kilometers. The line, with its 10 stations, weaves through Riyadh's rich tapestry of history and modernity. The orange line mirrors the city's dynamic growth, covering 29.6 kilometers, from Abdul Rahman bin Uf Road to Mohammed bin Saud Road. Its 8 stations serve as nodes connecting residential communities with the broader urban grid. Lastly, we have the yellow line and the purple line, which completes the network spectrum, ensuring that the educational, governmental, and leisure domains within Riyadh are seamlessly interlinked, enhancing the city's accessibility and livability. Key interchange stations are strategically positioned to facilitate easy transitions between lines, embodying the project's vision of a cohesive, efficient urban transit system. This interconnectedness extends beyond the metro, with feeder bus services and park and ride facilities woven into the fabric of Riyadh's transportation ecosystem, ensuring that the metro serves as the backbone of a comprehensive, integrated public transport strategy. So, now we know where they go, but how do they look? The architectural ethos of the Riyadh metro stations is rooted in a philosophy that marries functionality with aesthetic elegance. Where the rich heritage of Saudi Arabia is woven into the fabric of modern design principles, creating spaces that are landmarks of cultural and architectural significance. Each station is designed to be an oasis of comfort and convenience for passengers, with spacious concourses, easy navigation, and amenities that cater to the needs of a diverse population. Among the many stations, certain stars shine with particular brilliance designed by renowned architects, who brought their unique vision to the Riyadh Metro project. In the heart of Riyadh's growing financial hub, Zaha Hadid, renowned for her innovative approach to architectural design, imbued the King Abdul Financial District Metro Station with the essence of fluidity, drawing inspiration from the sweeping dunes of the Arabian desert. The station's silhouette echoes the undulating forms of sand dunes carved by the wind, presenting a facade that is both mesmerizing and evocative of the region's natural beauty. This design philosophy represents a departure from conventional architectural norms, embracing instead a narrative that blends the organic with the geometric, the timeless with the avant-garde. The station's exterior is a symphony of curves and swoops, a dynamic interplay of shadow and light that changes with the passage of the sun. The use of reflective materials and glass amplifies this effect, creating a luminous beacon in the financial district. The fluidic form isn't just an aesthetic choice, but a functional one, designed to facilitate the natural flow of passengers, guiding them through the space with intuitive ease. Moving just a few kilometers from the heart of the financial district, we find Qasr al-Hokm station, a remarkable embodiment of Riyadh's storied past and its vibrant future. This station is a confluence of history and modernity, paying homage to the architectural and cultural legacy of the region, while serving the needs of a rapidly evolving city. The design of the station is a thoughtful reflection of traditional Naji architecture, renowned for its distinctive mud-brick structures that have sheltered the inhabitants of the Arabian Peninsula for centuries. The station's facade is a modern re-imaging of this ancient style, incorporating the geometric patterns, color palettes, and materials that characterize Naji design, seamlessly blending them with contemporary construction techniques. The station's strategic location near key historical landmarks, such as the Masmak Fortress and the old Riyadh city walls, positions it as a bridge between epochs. It serves as a cultural landmark, offering both residents and visitors a gateway to explore the rich tapestry of their history. The architectural elements within the station, from intricately designed mashrabiyahs that filter sunlight, to the courtyards that echo the communal spaces of traditional Najdi homes. Tells the story of a city that cherishes its past while marching confidently toward the future. Moving northwards into the busy epicenter of Riyadh's economic activity, we encounter Olaya Metro Station, an architectural manifestation of the city's march towards global stature. The Olaya Metro Station distinguishes itself through its sleek, contemporary design, a visual metaphor for Riyadh's rapid transformation and its ambitions on the global area. The station's architecture is defined by clean lines and the use of modern materials, creating a space that is both functional and aesthetically striking. The extensive use of glass and steel not only imbues the station with a sense of openness and light, but also shows the architectural language of the surrounding skyscrapers, integrating the station seamlessly into the financial district's skyline. The strategic placement of the metro station serves as a center within the city's transportation network, offering easy access to business, retail, and leisure destinations. Its location underscores the station's role in enhancing the connectivity and accessibility of Riyadh's financial core, facilitating the daily routines of professionals and contributing to the district's vibrancy and economic vitality. Beneath the bustling streets and skyscrapers of Riyadh, a marvel of modern engineering has taken shape. The construction of the Riyadh Metro's underground tunnels is an odyssey of engineering expertise. Burrowing through the city's substrata, these tunnels are constructed using advanced tunnel boring machines, which meticulously carve out the metro's subterranean pathways. This method, known as the shale tunneling technique, allows for the precise and efficient excavation of tunnels, minimizing surface disruption in a densely populated urban environment. The design of these tunnels incorporates state-of-the-art reinforcement technologies, ensuring structural integrity against natural and anthropogenic stresses. Special attention is given to waterproofing and ventilation systems, creating a safe and comfortable environment for passengers. Moving up from the depths, the Riyadh Metro's elevated tracks present a different set of engineering feats. These elevated sections are supported by towering piers, designed with aesthetics and durability in mind. The use of pre-stressed concrete and steel in their construction ensures longevity and resilience, with designs that complement the city's skyline. The elevated tracks navigate the complexities of their urban landscape, weaving through neighborhoods and over natural obstacles with minimal footprint. This aerial component of the metro system provides passengers with panoramic views of the city and also exemplifies sustainable urban transit, reducing the need for land acquisition and mitigating environmental impacts. At the core of the Riyadh Metro's transformative impact lies a suite of advanced technologies, each component meticulously chosen to redefine the standards of public transit. They have seamlessly been integrating state-of-the-art rolling stock with unparalleled operational excellence to redefine urban transit. The heart of the system beats with a fleet of environmentally sustainable trains, equipped with regenerative braking and aerodynamic designs to enhance energy efficiency, while advanced climate control and real-time information systems within the carriages ensure passenger comfort and convenience. At the operational helm, sophisticated control centers employ cutting-edge technology to ensure seamless service and paramount safety, with automated train control systems and driverless technologies enhancing reliability and efficiency. Complementing this technological prowess are rigorous safety and security measures, from extensive surveillance systems to advanced fire detection, all underpinned by a commitment to universal accessibility, ensuring a safe, inclusive journey for all passengers. And there you have it. We hope you enjoyed the safe ride with us. And if you enjoyed the ride, leave a subscribe and a like. We would appreciate that. And before you go, let us know in the comments section below what you are interested in seeing in our future videos. See you in the next one!